Graphs, a powerful data structure that can be used to solve a lot of problems, and the one that we will solve in this video is one of them. We will solve the loud and rich problem. In the loud and rich problem, we have a group of n people, each one of them has a value that represents its quietness, and we have a bunch of relations xy that mean that x is richer than y. And the desired output is an array of n elements, where output of I represents the least quiet person that has equal to or more money than the person I. An example is better to understand. We have 8 people, here are their respective quietness. And we have these relations. For example, the first one is 1-0. It means that person 1 is richer than person 0. Don't forget that richness is transitive, so if A is richer than B and B is richer than C, then A is richer than C. So for person 0, we know that his quietness is 3, and person 1, who is richer than person 0, has a quietness of 2. But by transitivity, 2 is richer than 0, 3 is richer than 0, same thing for 4, 5, and 6. And the least quiet person among them is person 5, who has a quietness of 1, so output of 0 should be 5. Trying to understand things this way is a mess, because it's quite difficult to visualize the different relations. And to organize things, we will use a graph, a directed graph where vertices represent people, and an edge u to v means that v is richer than u. By doing so, for each person, we can easily check people that are richer by doing a depth-first search traversal. For example, for person 0, if we perform DFS starting from there, we reach 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 5. They represent people that are richer than person 0. We just take the one that has the smallest value in terms of quietness. First of all, why did I think of using a graph while solving this problem? I did so for two reasons. The first reason is that we have relations between elements that can represent vertices. And the second reason is that this relation is transitive, which means that DFS can be a good solution if we need to traverse all the related vertices, as we want to do here to find all the people that are richer than the actual person. Okay, now that we have our graph, we can continue our example. For person 0, we said that output of 0 is 5. For person 1, DFS reaches these vertices, and the least quiet person among them is 5, so output of 1 is 5. With person 2, we don't have the information of someone richer than him, so the least quiet person that has equal to or more money than him is himself. We put output of 2 equal to 2. Person 3, richer people are 4, 6, and 5, the least quiet is 5, his quietness is 1. Person 4, same case as person 2, is himself. Person 5, same thing. Person 6, same thing. Person 7, richer people are 3, 4, 6, and 5, but 7 is still less quiet than them, so output of 7 is 7, he has a quietness of 0. This graph is a directed acyclic graph. It has no cycles, because we cannot have something like A richer than B, B richer than C, and C richer than A. So we don't need to use a set of visited vertices to avoid infinite recursion. But before calling the DFS function, we still need to check if we don't already have the result of the actual vertex to avoid repeating the same work. So our DFS function takes 4 parameters, the graph, the source vertex from where we start the DFS traversal, the one whose we want to find the least quiet person that has equal to or more money than it, it also takes the quietness array and the output array. Then inside the function, we use a variable least quiet that initially starts at the actual vertex, because if the actual vertex has no neighbors or if all of them are not less quiet, then we consider it as the least quiet person related to it, as we did with 2, 4, 5, 6, and 7 in this example. Now for each neighbor, if we don't already have its value in the output, we call DFS to calculate it. Then least quiet becomes the minimum between least quiet and output of neighbor. The comparison key is their quietness. After traversing all the neighbors, we put least quiet in output of the actual vertex. And in the loud and rich function, we first need to make the graph, because remember that the input is the quietness of each person and their relations, not the graph. To create the graph, we're gonna use an adjacency list, implemented with an array of n sets in our case, where n is the number of people. Now for each relation in richer, we know that relation of 0 is richer than relation of 1, so we add person 0 to the neighbors of person 1. We also need the output array, which is an array of n elements initialized to none because we don't have their value yet. Now, we need to traverse the different people to fill the output array by calling DFS, and in our problem, people are represented with values from 0 to n-1, where n is the length of quiet, so for person in range of n, if we don't have the value yet, we call DFS starting from it. After the loop, we have our output array filled, we return it. Even if we may call the DFS function multiple times, but we are not repeating the work, so we are traversing the graph only once. And the time complexity of traversing a graph with DFS is of length of v plus length of e, where length of v is the number of vertices and length of e the number of edges. Here the number of vertices is the number of people, which is n, and the number of edges is the length of Richter, the relations array. Let's call it m. So the time complexity of this algorithm is of m plus m. And for the space complexity, creating the graph is considered as using extra space, so the space complexity is also of m plus m. We reach the end of this video. What you need to understand from this one is that you may need a graph even if the problem you're solving doesn't explicitly mention it, so you better know when and how to use a graph. I hope that you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next one.